In the news, Disney announced the complete cast list for the upcoming live-action Lion King movie via their Twitter page. The cast includes Donald Glover, Beyoncé, James Earl Jones, Seth Rogen, John Oliver, and more. So there really was only one name that we were waiting on, because most of this cast had been announced, we'd known who was gonna play what, but we had Nala's character, who we hadn't heard about, and it officially confirmed that it is going to be Beyoncé. Disney announced it on their Twitter, so if you're following Twitter, you've already seen this news. And if you did see it already, go ahead and throw in your comments below what you thought when you saw the news break about that final piece of the puzzle being added. Overall, this is a really good voice cast. I mean, there's a lot of talent in this voice cast. Outside of the names I already mentioned, we have people like John Connie, who you guys will remember from Captain America Civil War. He plays Black Panther's father. Before the bomb goes off, he's the reason that the Black Panther suits up, is his death from the bombing. So you guys are already familiar with the actor. You probably just didn't realize that was his name. And then Keegan-Michael Key from Key and Peele. And also he had that little short run that he did in Parks and Rec where he was Donna's boyfriend, then, you know, eventually husband. I mean, there's so much talent in this voice cast that I think it's set up for success, outside of the fact that it's Disney and they already knocked it out of the park with Jungle Book. Now they're stepping back to do the more iconic story, which is Lion King. Overall though, my excitement for this movie isn't that high unless I see something that makes me go, okay, so that's what they're doing different from the Jungle Book. All the technology and everything like that, yes, it will be better because we've had time to, but Jon Favreau and team have had time to work this technology over and just kind of build out what they've already done with the Jungle Book. So yes, the technology will be better for The Lion King. I'm not like high-fiving everybody about this news. Like, I think it's really cool that we've got this tremendous voice cast. However, I've already seen the technology at work. I loved The Jungle Book. I think it's a fantastic film, and the fact that it was all shot in a soundstage in LA and not the jungle is incredible, because that movie looks like it was shot on location in a jungle. And I've seen it once already. So unless something different happens with The Lion King, I'll be excited that it's another movie that is happening with Disney and everything else. But I can't really say like I'm uber pumped. So I'm curious to see what is going to be different about The Lion King that sets itself apart from The Jungle Book. Mark Strong is set to play Dr. Savannah, the lead villain in the Shazam movie. So Mark Strong, there was a lot of jokes going around online about the fact that he did that abysmal Green Lantern film back, you know, a while ago with Ryan Reynolds as Sinestro. So we get it, right? But he's also done movies like Kick-Ass. He did movies like Sherlock Holmes, right, with Robert Downey Jr. He was in The Imitation Game with Benedict Cumberbatch. He was also in both of the Kingsman movies. So we're not gonna hold all of the terrible and awfulness that was the Green Lantern against him for his performance. The movie itself, just bad. Taika Waititi was in that. He gave us Thor Ragnarok. He's given us, you know, What We Do in the Shadows. He also helped with Flight of the Conchords. So just because you have one misstep, we're not gonna throw you under the bus for all of it, right? You come out, you do a great job, and we're looking forward to your next performance, whatever that may be. So with Mark Strong coming out to play this villainous doctor, I had no idea who this guy was, because all I knew about Shazam was that he's a kid that turns into a superhero, right? He says Shazam, boom, he's like a superhero, like Superman, and he fights Black Adam. So I had to do some research. I had to look into this to find out who is this doctor character. And apparently he's right up there with Black Adam. And so I sat back and I went, well, why would they want to use this guy first when they've already announced we're going to have a Black Adam movie with The Rock? So you gotta tie these in eventually. So how does this all work? So this makes sense now that I've done the reading research on this, right? To get the backstory on how these things can all connect together. I get it now. So if they're going, and this is an if, we don't know anything about the story. This is just a big speculative if. So if they're going this route to have like the doctor like have some type of trauma where he needs the Shazam magic, and that's why he's fighting Shazam, is to get the magic to heal himself, but somehow finds out that there's another way, and it's through this Black Adam tomb, and then he resurrects the Black Adam, problem solved. Black Adam comes to life in the modern time, he has no idea what's going on, he views himself a god over all of these human creatures that are addicted to cell phones, that are addicted to Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, etc. And he's like, nope, I'm going to be the ruler and the king over all of these people. And then him and Shazam go at it. Makes perfect sense to me. That's probably not what's going to happen, but it makes perfect sense to me after I did the research. Mark Strong, I think, can really pull this off. He is really good at playing intelligent characters. If the character is a hero or a villain, it doesn't matter. Mark Strong has the background and he's got the look and he's got the emotional intensity to deliver hero or villain intelligently on screen to us so that he's believable. Whether he's, you know, a yellowish monster floating through space with a ring, or, you know, he's fighting Sherlock Holmes, it doesn't matter. Mark can do it. And I'm looking forward to seeing more from the Shazam movie, because as we discussed on a previous episode, I think there's a lot of room to make this a much more lighthearted film, even though it could be dealing with some very dark themes because of what the Doctor might be trying to cure on himself. Sound off below with your thoughts. Jean-Claude Van Damme is set to lead the new film The Bouncer, which is being directed by Julien Leclerc. According to Variety, Van Damme will star as Lucas, a nightclub bouncer in his 50s who gets thrown in jail, loses custody of his daughter, and is then recruited by Interpol to stop a Dutch ringleader operating in Belgium in exchange for the custody of his daughter. The Bouncer begins shooting in January of 2018. I had to double check this news because I didn't believe it was an actual story when I read it, because it sounds absolutely ludicrous. You have a bouncer. He's a bar bouncer, but Interpol needs him? What? This movie sounds bananas. And when I read this, I was like, this can't be real. It's real. And now we're going to talk about it. I can't wait to see more about this film. This sounds like something that we would see for like $20-30 million, like a Liam Neeson picture, like where he's on like the new movie where he's on a train, or his Taken films. This sounds like something off the wall, made for cheap, cheaper, just a good time. I couldn't believe, when you say Jean-Claude Van Damme is coming back to play a bouncer, my first thought was Roadhouse, because that's everyone's first thought when you hear a movie about a bouncer. But then I was like, okay, and then it's taking place in Europe and Interpol needs him. I don't get it. Nothing ties together in like any type of reality, unless he's like some special forces like veteran, and then like he's just doing bouncing because that's what he likes to do and he doesn't need like a high paying job because of whatever reason. He's just like, yeah, I like to be a bouncer. Okay, but then Interpol needs him? This sounds so ridiculous. I can't wait to see more, because it sounds like Jean-Claude Van Damme is going to do what Jean-Claude Van Damme does best, and that is he is going to kick some booty. I can't wait. This synopsis that I just read does not make sense at all. Why would Interpol need a bouncer? Ludicrous. But it has the potential to be just such a fun, ridiculous, turn your brain off action flick, like similar to something like The Expendables, where you just sit down in the theater, you have a giant bucket of popcorn, and you're just shoveling popcorn in your face as bombs are going off and guns are just shooting everything and explosions, car crashes, people getting punched in the face, thrown off of buildings. It sounds like it could be a crazy good time. I can't wait. I just want to see more from this film. Give me a trailer. I'm ready for the trailer today. Natalie Portman will be casting her vocal talent in the new animated film being produced by Bold Films, entitled Foxy Trotter. The story is about a motorcycle riding rock and roll photographer in the early 1970s trying to capture the perfect rock photo while also trying to save the universe from Gunter, Foxy's arch rival. The film is described as a wild mix of Barbarella meets Sausage Party meets Easy Rider. This week is the week for news that makes no sense. Are you two stories in a row that just make me go, what? I love this story. I can't wait to, it's animated, so you have all the potential in the world to do whatever you want. There's no limitations because it's animated, so you can have the craziest fight scenes, explosions, whatever. It's going to be rock and roll, so you're going to just like have this rock and roll band. Why does a photographer have an arch rival? It makes no sense. And the arch rival of a rock and roll photographer is trying to destroy the universe. This is madness. I can't wait. It's insanity. I am so excited. These last two stories, I was like, these can't be real. These are real. I am excited. So I don't know what more from this story is going to unfold that will make me more excited for this. If the first trailer drops and the animation looks kind of then okay, then I'll be a little bit bummed. But in general, This story, just like the Jean-Claude Van Damme story we just talked about, sounds so over the top and ridiculous. I cannot wait. These films, they just sound like a fun time at the movies. Turn your brain off, get ready for some action, and have a ball. Plus, we get Natalie Portman. Now, she's going to be doing vocal talent for the best friend of Foxy, which is fine. That's great. I just want more from this. Show me that first trailer. I'm ready for it right now. If you can get me the Jean-Claude Van Damme movie and this movie trailer on the same day, that's an early Christmas present for this guy. So now you take Barbarella, Sausage Party, and Easy Rider, you throw the 1970s rock and roll vibe to it, and you make it animated. This has all of the possibility to either be tremendously wonderful or horrifically stupid. I don't really see people coming out of the theater going, I really saw what they were going for, I just don't think they achieved it. I think people are gonna walk out of the theater and be like, wow, that was the biggest piece of garbage I've ever seen. Or, that movie made no sense, but it was amazing. That's the type of reactions I think this movie is going to produce. I think people are either going to love it or they're going to be like, why did I just waste my time in that theater? Either way, I just want to see the first trailer. Gimme, gimme, gimme. Honorable mentions this week. Red Sonja is being made into a feature film by Millennium Media. Jon Hamm is set to star in the supernatural thriller Off Season. Elois Mumford is joining Billy Crystal and Ben Schwartz in the new comedy We Are Unsatisfied. Anna Kendrick posted a first look at her new Christmas movie Noelle on her Instagram. Star Wars The Last Jedi released a new 45-second teaser trailer online. All right, so that's it for this week's news segment. There's always so much news that drops all week long, we can't possibly get to it all in this show, which is once a week. If anything popped off that you had a question about or you'd like my opinion on, go ahead and throw it in the comments below. Also, if there was anything that jumped off and you were like, this is super dope, share it with us in the comments section and let's keep the movie conversations going all week long.